Well, yes, Vandana. In fact, that has been rolled back yesterday itself. There was a huge debate on social media, especially Delhi government people, officials, they were engaging with it. The Aam Aadmi Party leaders were engaging with that debate, whether Delhi is prepared, the health workers of Delhi, are they prepared to get that much of pressure? Because right now, whatever the cases in Delhi is increasing every other day, and not just that, pressure on the health worker is also really high. So that was the point what the Delhi CM Mr. Arvind Kejriwal was pointing out, that if the 5 days quarantine is made for asymptomatic people with symptoms, then it is going to bring a huge pressure on the health workers. Right now, we have already seen that there were some hospitals where the resident doctors were complaining that they have not received salary, and they have been working night and day without any break. So keeping all these things in mind, yesterday the compulsory mandatory quarantine 5 days has been rolled back, and to see what the Delhi government is going to do with the people who need immediate care in with respect to coronavirus. Remember that on Friday we reported that a lot of hotels are being converted into COVID-19 speciality, and Delhi government has promised that they are going to bring 80,000 beds very soon.
All right, stay on with us, Nitesha. Let's go back across to Stacey. Stacey, Karnataka, of course, doing much better than Delhi, at least. In fact, we also have Neetu Regukumar, who joins us from Trivandrum. Neetu, remember, the Kerala Chief Minister has hit out at the Congress for the comments that they had used against the Health Minister K.K. Shailaja, where, in fact, the Karnataka Pradesh Congress President had, in fact, gone on to call her a Nipah princess and a COVID queen. The Kerala Chief Minister had said that this is just not acceptable.
The Kerala Pradesh Congress Committee Chief Mullapalli Ramachandran has went on to make remarks against the state health minister, and in the daily press meet with the media, what the chief minister has said is that he stood by the minister and said that the opposition is trying to derail the activities by singling out the minister. He went on to say that these outrage and remarks are stemming from a particular mindset, and that is definitely anti-women. And this cannot be accepted. So very strong words coming in from the Chief Minister of Kerala against Mullapalli Ramachandran, as well as the Congress, stating that these were the steps that they have taken at a time like this. He also criticized them in the manner in which the protest was conducted day before yesterday, without following social distancing norms. Now, in the state of Kerala, as far as numbers are concerned, yesterday recorded the single highest day spike, with 127 cases being reported in a day. Of this, 87 people were those who have returned from abroad, and 36 are people who had come back from other states. Four are through contacts and one was a health worker. So these are the kind of statistics that the Chief Minister and the government is also depending on when they say that COVID negatives, or rather COVID testing, is required before expats get onto those flights, because otherwise they are capable of infecting many people within the flight when they are sitting. So this is something which has again become a political contention, mm-hmm. with the opposition Congress raising protest, stating that the government don't want expats to come back. Ramesh Anitala and the Congress leaders were in a sit-in protest also. This is something which is being debated at the moment, but as far as the numbers go, there are about 1,450 active cases in the state. The numbers are steadily increasing. This was expected once the state started opening up, and once people started coming in from abroad and from other states. So now, from 25th of this month, the Chief Minister says that everybody insisting on COVID test for expats before they board the flights.
Right, but the mandatory COVID testing for expats becoming a political flashpoint as well. Thank you, Neetu, for joining us. Let's also go across now to Ritangshu, who joins us with the latest figures on the Magic Wall.